Let us take this question. It says we have AB whole complement plus A complement B is equal to C. Now find what is AC whole complement plus A complement C. We need to find the value of AC whole complement plus A complement C. So let us take this equation. We have AC whole complement plus A complement C. In this case, you can apply De Morgan's law here. So it can be done as A complement plus C complement plus A complement C, right? Plus A complement C. So it can also be written as, take A complement as common. So it is 1 plus C complement, which is equal to A complement plus C complement. Okay. And we know what is the value of C. The value of C is, C can be written as C is equal to AB whole complement plus A complement B. Again, you can do the same thing here also. So it can be written as A complement plus B complement. Put these values here. This above equation, it is A complement plus C complement. Put the value of C here. So it is A complement plus B complement whole complement, which can be written as A complement plus A dot B whole complement complement. It is A complement plus AB. Distribute A complement. So it is A complement plus A dot A complement plus B. And this is equal to 1. So it can be written as A complement plus B. So the value of this expression is A complement plus B. Okay, so it is very easy here in this case. Now let us solve the next questions. Now let us take the next question. It says, prove that AB whole complement plus A complement plus AB whole complement is equal to 0. We need to prove this thing. Okay. So first of all, let us try to expand this. It can be written as A complement plus B complement plus A complement plus AB whole complement, right? Here in this case, you can see we have written this expression like this by using De Morgan's law. Okay. Now in this case, you can see we have A complement and A complement. We don't have to write it twice, just write it once. So it can be written as A complement plus B complement plus AB whole complement. Now you can distribute A over this, or you can distribute B over this, that is your personal choice. So it can be written as A complement plus A dot A complement plus B complement whole complement. We have distributed A complement over AB. So it can also be written as, this is 1. So it is A complement plus B complement whole complement, right? But you already know what is B plus B complement. This is equal to 1. So it can be written as A complement plus 1 whole complement. And this complete expression is 1. And the complement of 1 is equal to 0. Right? So we'll get 0. Hence, this complete expression is going to give you 0. So left hand side is equal to the right hand side. Hence proved. Okay? Now let us take the B part. In the B part, they are saying we have AB plus AC whole complement plus AB complement C dot AB plus C is equal to 1. Okay. Now let us try to do this. We have AB plus AC whole complement plus, open the brackets, you will get AB complement C dot AB plus AB complement C dot C. Okay. Now you already know we have B dot B complement, which is equal to 0. So it can be written as AB plus AC whole complement plus AC dot 0 plus AB complement C. And this complete expression is now 0. So it is AB plus AC whole complement plus AB complement C. Now you can either, you can open this, you can apply De Morgan's law here, or you can distribute A over these two expressions also. Let us do both the things together. Okay, so first of all, take A as common between these two. So it can, it is, if you take A as common, so it is B plus B complement C plus, we have AC whole complement, so apply De Morgan's law. So it can be written as A complement plus C complement. Again, distribute B over this. So it is A, B plus B complement dot B plus C plus A complement plus C complement. And this is equal to 1. So it is A, B plus C plus A complement plus C complement. If you open the brackets, it can be written as AB plus AC plus A complement plus C complement. Right? So you can distribute A over this, and you can distribute C over this. That is a better way to do. So it can be written as A plus A complement, B plus A complement plus A plus C complement dot C plus C complement. So this is one, this is one. So it can be written as A complement plus B plus A plus C complement, and this, it is equal to B plus C complement plus 1, which is equal to 1 itself. So hence you can say that this complete expression can be minimized to 1. Okay, so we have done these three questions. We have already done this, we have done this, we have done this. Now let us take the part number C here. Now let us take the next question. It says we have a B complement plus ABC whole complement plus A B plus AB complement whole complement is equal to 0. We have to prove this. Okay, so here you can take A as common, so it can be written as B complement plus BC whole complement plus A. You can distribute B over this, so it is B plus A dot B plus B complement whole complement, which can be further written as, this is, distribute B over this, so it is A B complement plus B dot B complement plus C whole complement plus A, this is equal to 1, so it is A plus B whole complement. Okay, again this is equal to 1, so this complete can be written as A dot B complement plus C whole complement plus A plus B whole complement. Okay, again you can also open it here. If you open these brackets, then you will get A plus AB, and here you can apply the absorption law, because you already know if you do A plus AB, now it can be written as A. Okay, so this complete can be written as A complement, apply De Morgan's law here, so A complement plus B complement plus C whole complement plus A whole complement. Again in this case you can take, we have, you can see we have A complement and A, so you can write it one here. So it can be written as 1 plus B complement plus C whole complement, which is equal to this. If you add 1 to any expression, so this is equal to 1. So if you do 1 complement, which is equal to 0. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So hence we have. In the previous video, we have already discussed the problem number 1, 2 and 3. Now let us discuss the next problem. It is saying, if we have AB plus A B plus C plus B dot B plus C, then it is equal to B plus AC. Okay, so we have to prove this thing. As you can see from the question, this question is very easy. So let us first of all take it. This is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. Let us take the left hand side first, LHS. Left hand side is saying we have AB plus A dot B plus C plus B dot B plus C. Now in this case, you can take open these brackets, so this can also be written as AB plus AB plus AC plus B dot B plus B dot C. Now instead of writing it two times, you can write it once, so it is AB plus AC plus B plus BC. Right, now if you have B plus BC, between these two you can take B as common, or you can just directly apply the absorption law, but let me just do it in a simpler way. So it is AB plus AC plus B 1 plus C, and this is equal to 1, so it can be written as AB plus AC plus B. Now between this and this, you can apply absorption law. So it can also be written as B 1 plus A plus AC. And this is equal to 1. So it is B plus AC, which is equal to the right hand side. Hence proved. Okay. So you know this is one of the easiest question in this case. Now let us take the next question here. Now we have done these four questions. Now let us take the next question. It says we have to prove if we have A B complement C plus BD plus A complement B complement, it is equal to B complement C plus A complement B complement. Okay, so this is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. So let us take the left hand side and let us try to make it equal to the right hand side. Okay, so here we have AB complement C plus BD plus A complement B complement. You can open the brackets here, so it can also be written like this: AB complement C plus AB complement BD plus A complement B complement. Now in this case, this is 0, so this expression becomes 0. So it can also be written like this: AB complement C plus A complement B complement. Now here we have A and here we have A complement. So we will distribute A over this, but how we will distribute? To distribute, we have to take B as common. So here we can also take it like this, take B as B complement as common. So this is AC plus B, AC plus A complement. Further, you can distribute A complement over this. So this can be written as B complement A plus A complement dot A complement plus C, which is equal to B complement. This is equal to 1. So it is A complement plus C, which is equal to A complement B complement plus B complement C, and this is equal to the right hand side, RHS, right? So hence proved. So we have done E also. So these questions are very simple. You can check it. So I'm just doing these questions for your practice. So I want to provide as much practice as possible, but let us do the next question here. Okay. So the next question is saying we have this one, which is A plus A complement dot AB plus ABC complement, which is equal to AB, right? So take the left hand side. Here we have A plus A complement AB plus ABC complement, right? So this is equal to 1, we already know, and between these two we can take AB as common. So it can also be written like this: 1 dot take AB as common, 1 plus C complement, and this is equal to 1, right? So this can be written as 1 dot AB dot 1, which is equal to AB itself, which is equal to right hand side. So it is one of the easiest one. Okay, so we have done this one also. Let us try the next one. It says we have A B complement plus A C complement, B C plus B C complement dot A B C is equal to 0. We have to prove that this is equal to 0, right? So in this case, how can do? Okay, first of all, let us do one thing. Let us take this expression and let us try to open it. So here we have A B complement plus A C complement. Take B as common, so it is C plus C complement dot A B C, not 0. Now in this complete expression, this is equal to 1, this is equal to 1. So it can also be written like this: A B complement plus A C complement dot B dot A B C is equal to 0. Now if you open these brackets, then what will you get? So it is A B complement dot, you can write B only one, so A B C plus AC complement dot ABC. And here, because we got B complement dot B and here we got C complement dot C, that is why this expression is 0. So it can also be written as AC dot 0 plus it can also be written as AB dot 0, which is equal to 0 itself, which is equal to the right hand side. So hence this one is also proved. Okay, so we have proved the G option also. Now let us take the H, option number H, or question number H. So question number H is saying we have A B plus C dot AB plus AC whole complement is equal to AB. Okay, take the left hand side, LHS. So it is AB plus AC dot AB plus AC whole complement. Okay, now you can apply De Morgan's law over this. You can apply De Morgan's law here. It is very easy here. Let us do it. So we have AB plus AC dot AB complement dot AC complement. If you open these brackets, then this is equal to AB plus AC dot AB complement dot AC whole complement. But because we got AC and AC complement, then this makes it 0. So it can also be written like this: AB plus AB complement dot 0, and which makes it 0. So it is AB, which is equal to the right hand side. Okay, so this one is also very easy. Let us take the next one. It says we have A plus BC whole complement dot AB complement plus ABC whole complement. It should be equal to A complement BC. Now in this case, you can apply De Morgan's law here. First of all, apply De Morgan's law here and apply De Morgan's law here. So this can be written as A plus B complement plus C complement whole complement dot this is AB complement plus this is A complement plus B complement plus C complement, which is equal to A plus B complement C complement whole complement dot this is take B complement as common, so it is A plus 1 plus A complement plus C complement, which can be written as A plus B complement C complement whole complement dot A complement plus B complement plus C complement, right? So now again you can apply De Morgan's law here, so it can also be written like this: A complement dot B complement complement dot C complement complement dot A complement plus B complement plus C complement, which is further A complement BC dot A complement plus B complement plus C complement. Now open the bracket, so it is A complement BC dot A complement plus A complement BC dot B complement plus A complement BC dot C complement. Now because here we got B and B complement and here we got C and C complement, because of these two, these expressions became zero. So it is A complement BC, which is equal to the right hand side, right? So hence this is also proof. This one is also very easy. Let us take the next question here. The next question says we have A plus B complement C dot A plus B complement C whole complement, it should be equal to A. We have to prove it, right? So let us take the left hand side. It says A plus B complement C, A plus B complement C whole complement. So it can be written as A plus B complement C, A plus, apply De Morgan's law here, so it is B complement complement plus C complement, which is equal to A plus B complement C, A plus B plus C complement. Now open the bracket, so it is A plus A B complement C plus B complement dot B dot C plus B complement dot C complement. This is 0 and this is also 0. So it is A plus A B complement C, take A as common, so it is 1 plus B complement C, which is equal to A itself, which is equal to the right hand side. So hence this is also proved. Okay, now we are with the last question. So last question says we have ABC whole complement dot A plus B plus C whole complement, it should be equal to A complement B complement C complement. Okay, so let us take the left hand side. It is ABC whole complement dot A plus B plus C whole complement. Apply De Morgan's law in here and here also. So if you apply De Morgan's law here, so it is A complement plus B complement plus C complement dot, if you apply De Morgan's law here, so this can be written as A complement dot B complement dot C complement. Open the brackets again, so you will get A complement dot A complement B complement C complement plus B complement dot A complement B complement C complement plus C complement dot A complement B complement C complement. So it can be written as A complement B complement C complement plus A complement B complement C complement plus A complement B complement C complement, which is equal to A B C, all these three complements, and which is equal to the right hand side, right? So hence this one is also proved. So you can see these questions are very easy questions. We have just taken this question, we have taken these questions for practice. So if you can solve this question, then it is well and good. If you cannot solve this question, then you can refer to these videos. And see, it is not necessary that you watch all these videos. So you can skip some part whenever you feel like, just by saying that, so if you know that you can solve these questions, then you can skip this part, there's no issues. Okay, let us move on to the next sections. which is functions of what is functionally complete sets and what are the different functional properties of those sets. Okay. Thank you.